Hello! In this video, we'll be covering random forests. Let's start by highlighting the association between decision trees and random forests. First, what is a forest? Well, just as in nature, a forest consists of many trees. So in a random forest, we have many decision trees, where the decision trees are created from random splits in the dataset. Now, let's take a look at a random forest algorithm. We start by having capital B number of trees we want to create. A small b represents a single tree, so we iterate from one tree to capital B, representing multiple trees. Next, we want to draw a bootstrap of Z star of size n from the training data. Bootstrapping is where you randomly select n data points with replacement from a set of data. This means that some data points may be chosen more than once, and some not at all. Note that there are two sources of randomness: randomness in the data and randomness in the feature splits. Afterwards, we want to grow the tree to the bootstrap data and recursively repeat these steps until we've reached a minimum node size, or n min. These steps are: first, choose a subset from the p features of size m. Then, pick the best variable split point among the m features. And finally, split the node into two daughter nodes. The last step of the algorithm, after all trees have been built, is to output the ensemble of trees. So why would we use random forests? What's the purpose of it when we have decision trees already? Imagine that you had a very large data set, maybe somewhere around 1 million observations with 10,000 attributes. Think about how large of a tree we would have to create if we did binary splits on this dataset. Let's take this decision tree for an example. Now, imagine we increased the dataset by a large amount and created a tree that looked like this. Comparing the size of these trees, the second one is multitudes larger than the first. If the first tree took a couple of minutes to classify and build, this tree might take a couple of hours or even days, assuming we scale these models the same. The point of this is to illustrate that decision trees don't work very well with very large datasets because the depth of the tree becomes too large and it'll take too long to classify a data point. Since a random forest is just a compilation of decision trees, the dataset can be split into n smaller datasets, creating n decision trees. These decision trees can now be built in parallel, increasing the overall speed. This technique is often used with very large datasets, where it's better to split the data over many machines rather than storing all of the data onto one machine. Once again, each machine can build a tree based on the data that was stored on it. Thus, each tree will be built on a different subset of the larger dataset. When scaling to large datasets, the averaging of the trees provides consistent results that are accurate. This may not be true for other classifiers, such as KNN. The averaging of trees, or any estimator for that matter, is called bagging. This allows random forests to be a very reliable estimator. Thanks for watching.